So friends, in this session we will discuss some unsolved numericals of the time value of money from the Macmillan book. So friends, see 11th numerical. See, if I invest 5000 today and expect to sell at 10000 in the 8 years, if the rate of interest is 5%, so is this a good deal? And what happen if the interest rate is 12%? So friends, see here how to solve that. That means what is happening here, see, you are investing 5000 rupees and you are selling something, and whatever you have done the investment, you will encash that investment at the 10000 rupees, right? You are investing 5000 and you are getting 10000 rupees after 8 years. They have given rate of interest is the 5%, the number of years is the 8. So they are asking to us whether this deal is good or not. So friends, how to solve this type of numerical? This is the very, very important, because IIBF is generally asking this type of numerical. So friends, see here, today I have invested 5000 and in future I will get 10000, right? Suppose in 2020 I have invested, this year I have invested, suppose in 2020 I have invested 5000 rupees, and after 8 years, that means after in 2028 I will get 10000 rupees. That means after 8 years I will get that much of value, but I don't know, right, what is the value of 10000 today. How to compare 5000 and 10000 in the future? That's why we have to calculate present value of the 10000. So remember, always remember, we have to calculate the present value of the future cash flow, then only we can compare two present values. Okay, now see, what is the present value formula? We have future value is equal to present value into x. That is our traditional formula, where x is equal to 1 plus r raised to n. So first calculate x is 1 plus r raised to n. 1 plus, what is r? R is a 5%, that means 5% means 0.05. okay, to remove percentage sign, divide by 100, so you will get 1.05 raised to power n. So you have to calculate 1.05 to power 8. How to calculate? Using the simple calculator. If you don't know, you can watch the link in the description box. Okay, now you will, when you calculate x, just put the value. We have present value formula for future value is equal to present value into x. So present value will become future value divided by x. So our future value is 10000, so divided by just x. X is our 1.4774. okay, so when you divide by x, you will get present value of the 10000. That means whatever the amount you are getting after 8 years, that is the 10000, the value of 10000 today is only the 6768 rupees and 64 paise. Okay, and what is the amount we have invested? We have invested the 5000 rupees. That means the future present value of the future cash flow is more. Okay, that's why the deal should be okay. That means the deal is the best. That means if the present value of the future cash flow is more than the today's investment, then it's worthy to invest. And therefore it is a good deal. Okay, so in this fashion you have to solve this type of case study. Investment, whether investment is good or bad, you have to calculate the present value. Similarly, what they are asking, what if the rate of interest is the 12%? Suppose, so we have to again repeat all the calculation. That means second numerical is there. They have given 5000 rupees purchase and after 8 year for 10000 I will sell. And rate of interest they have given, here is the 12%. So you have to repeat all the procedure by changing the rate. Instead of 5%, you have to take the 12%. And this is homework for you. Okay, you have to solve this case study using the 12% rate of interest, and you have to comment your answer to the in the comment box. Okay, now I will move to the next unsolved numerical. So see friends, here the next unsolved numerical is the 13th numerical, that is the from the Macmillan book. ओके व्हाट दे हैव गिवन, हाउ मच अमाउंट शुड बी डिपॉजिटेड एट द बिगिनिंग ऑफ ईच ईयर फॉर 10 ईयर्स इन ऑर्डर टू प्रोवाइड अ सम ऑफ 5 लाख एट द एंड ऑफ 10 ईयर एंड रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट इज 8% गिवन. दैट मीन्स what is the scenario actually, suppose a customer came to a bank and ask you, sir I want 5 lakh rupees of sum after 10 years, so that how much amount should I deposit in the RD account, and RD is annual, and so you have to tell to that customer what amount he should deposit so that after 10 year he will get 5 lakh rupees. Okay, now see, we have to deposit some amount, we have and after 10 year we want 5 lakh, after 10 year we are wanting 5 lakh. See here, there is a constant cash flow of amount to be deposited. That means every year we are depositing at the beginning of the year. That means this is the annuity we have to calculate. We have to calculate the annuity. Annuity is the constant cash flow, that is we have to calculate. And the future value they have given 5 lakh rupees, that is 5 lakh rupees they want. And the rate of interest is given 8%. So we have formula, and this how it is depositing? It is depositing at the beginning of the each year. That means it is beginning of the period, and beginning of the period is nothing but the annuity due. And for a beginning of the period annuity due, we have the formula: future value is equal to A upon R into bracket X minus 1. So what will be A? Just rearrange the formula, you will get A is equal to future value into R divided by X minus 1. Where x is equal to 1 plus r raised to n. So x will become 1 plus r is nothing but the 8%. So 0.08 raised to power 10. So you have to calculate using the simple calculator. Okay. So you will get x is equal to 2.1589. If you don't know how to calculate higher powers, the link is in the description box. You can watch how to calculate the higher powers. Okay. Now once you calculate the higher power, that is 1.08 raised to power 10, you will get x value. Now next is thing is very simple, just put value in the formula. Just put future value is 5 lakh rupees, r is 0.08, and x is nothing but the 2.1589. so minus 1 you will get 1.1589. okay, and when you solve this you will get answer as the 3534515. That means if the customer deposit 34,515 rupees per year at the beginning of year, after 10 year he will get 10 lakh, so sum of 5 lakh rupees. Okay, this is also a very very important case study, and this type of numerical are generally called as the sinking fund. That means we want some money after some time, and that's why we are saving. That is called as basically a sinking fund. So we have completed the 13th numerical. Now we will move to the next numerical. So friends, see, this is the most important part of the numerical. You have to remember the formulas, right? And you should know how and what we have to calculate. Here they are asking how much amount should be deposited at the beginning of each year. That means we should come to know that it is constant cash flow. So it is annuity should be calculated. So we have future value. So use the formula for the future value, rearrange the formula and calculate the annuity. Okay, now we will move to the next numerical. See friends, next numerical is the unsolved numerical from the Macmillan book, and the question number 17. And that is the first A part we are going to see in this. See, if A invest 100 rupees at a 7% rate of interest for the 3 years, what will be the value at the end of 3 years? This is very basic question, very simple question. So I was thinking it should be kept for the homework. Okay, but let me explain. I will explain it in a brief manner. See friends, we have 100 rupees. You are investing at 7% rate of interest for the 3 years. And definitely it should be compound interest. They have not mentioned it, but we have to generally calculate for the compound interest, because simple interest is very easy to calculate. So they will not ask generally a simple interest. So you have to use the formula for the compound interest. We have formula for the compound interest, that is by traditional method you can solve. That is the present value they have given 100, rate of interest is 7%, that is 0.07, and n is 3 years, and we have to find the future value, that is nothing but the maturity value we have to find. Okay, so you can go by this formula, or you can go by our book formula. This is book method, future value is equal to present value into x, where x is nothing but the 1 plus r raised to n. Okay, present value they have given 100, okay, and x is nothing but the 1 plus r raised to n. So here rate of interest is 7%. So 1 plus 0.07 raised to power 3. For 3 years we have to calculate. So 3. So when you solve this, you will get answer. So you have to again comment the answer in the comment box. Okay, and remember there is a one traditional method also that you have all know, that is nothing but the sum is equal to p into bracket 1 plus r raised to n, where r is nothing but the rate of interest and p is your present value. And you can also go by this method or you can also go by this method. Both the formulas are same, just they have rearranged that formula. Previously, before joining the bank, you were studying this, you have joined the bank, so you have to deal in the present value and the future value. So in this fashion we have studied the three unsolved numerical in this session. So we will continue our discussion in the next session.